Good morning. This is Ametta. How are you doing today? Oh my goodness. It is Monday. I hope you had a good weekend. Today is the first day of this week. This is Seed of the Word in Ministry. And as I just said, I am Ametta. I greet you in the precious name of Jesus, my Lord and my Savior. Today I want to talk to you about the SOS found in the Bible. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you for today, for the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, yet your name is also unchanged. Empower us through your word today to see the warnings in your word and obey them. In Jesus' name, amen. There is a song that goes, there is no way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. God wants us to trust him and obey him. I have been thinking about how God gives seed to the sower. In doing so, my mind stayed on the first letter of each word. So, of sower. Seed of sower. And so I looked it up, and I decided to look up SOS. And I was reminded that it was a code to warn people of impending danger or troubles. But then there was the original SOS, which meant someone looking over shoulder. Someone is watching. And that was given out to them to remind them that people are watching them. Watch what you do and say. For us, it is the Almighty who is watching. In Psalms 121 and 5, the Lord watches over you. He is your shade at right hand. He is watching to perform and to protect us. In Jeremiah 1 and 12, it says, you have seen well, for I watch over you to perform my word. That is why we need that word hidden in our heart. When God watches over us, he will perform, help that word to become manifested. What a mighty God he is. He watches to keep us from harm and to see that his word is perfected in us. And he uses many things to perfect that word. A part of that task is SOS. God issues warnings to protect his children. He wants us to trust him. Psalms 46 and 10 says, be still and know that I am God. And so as we read the word, we find out what we know about God. Amen. In John 5 and 3, it says, for this loving God, that we keep his commandments, his commandments are not grievous. Amen. We keep his commandments. Jesus said, if my word abides in you, and you abide in me, you can ask what you will, and it shall be given to you of the Father. He also says, where two or three come together touching, in agreement, he will be in the midst. God is a loving Father, and he has set up some SOS to help keep us out of trouble. In Genesis, we see how he warned through Noah that a flood was coming. As Noah was preaching that word, and the flood and building that ark, the flood came. When the flood came, those who mocked him and laughed at him were drowned. The SOS had gone out, but they did not listen. Lot's wife was another one. She was warned not to look back, and she looked back. And we believe that that looking back means she looked back and thought, I'd rather be back there, which I knew, than to go forward. She wasn't trusting God. She was trusting what she knew. And it ended up being a catastrophe. And she turned into a pillar of salt. God is mighty towards us. He loves and wants us to be holy like him. So there are some SOS scriptures that can be applied to our everyday life. Matthew, Mark, and Luke heard the same warning about these things, about things that was going to come to pass before Jesus came back. These warnings was to keep us from being fearful. Mark, Luke, and also Matthew had heard the same things about the disturbances, wars, and things that were going to be going on. And of course, as we look around, we can see them too. But God does not want us to be fearful. God sent us an SOS about the people, what they would be like before he came back. In 2 Timothy 3:1, he says, "But know this, that in the last days, grievous times will come. For men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, arrogant, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, and unholy." God also sent us an SOS on how we should treat one another. In 1 Thessalonians 5:14, he says, "Exhort your brothers, admonish the disorderly, encourage the faint-hearted, support the weak, and be patient towards all people." And God also sent an SOS about how we can miss out on inheriting the kingdom of God. In 1 Corinthians 6:9, he says that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. And he gives us some examples of what the unrighteous is. He names that they will not inherit the kingdom of God, and that they are sexual immoral, they're idolaters, they are adulterers and prostitutes and homosexuals. He named all of these people to let us know this is the kind of situation that he does not want to see when he comes back. Paul understood the SOS message, and he cried loudly, Romans 21, "Therefore I urge you, brothers, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as living sacrifices unto God, which is your reasonable service, your spiritual service." As we consider these Bible warnings, we should heed them. The first step is to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. That means you're looking for him to guide you and tell you the truth. He sent the Holy Spirit through after Jesus came back to us to help lead us and guide us into all truth. Second, the Bible teaches us that if you search the scriptures, you will find him in that, and you will learn more about him. The Pharisees were searching the scriptures because they thought they could find eternal life. But Jesus let them know the scriptures would verify and testify about him. Thirdly, when it is possible, because of the pandemic, become a part of a fellowship of believers. And fourthly, heed the biblical SOS. Amen. It's a warning to us. God sent it. He is wonderful, and he sent it to protect us from all that is going on in the world. I want you to be able to sing like Vicky, "I just want you." If we have Jesus, we have everything. Amen. Be blessed of the Lord. Stay masked. Stay distancing. Gloves when necessary. Most of all, follow God. Read your Bible. In Jesus' name. And I will see you on Wednesday. Amen. Amen. God is good, and he's mighty.
Cheers, Lord.